Welcome to the second episode in the LightningChart JavaScript tutorial series. In this episode, we'll look into what LightningChart is capable of when it comes to different line charts. We will cover three different applications: static chart with multiple daytime data trends, static chart with multiple trends on individual y-axis, real-time chart with scrolling live data. This tutorial is targeted for developers who know the basics of JavaScript. We will be using TypeScript, which is almost identical. Start by opening and running the LightningChart TypeScript template. If this is unclear to you, please refer to the first tutorial or learn more in the video description. For this example, we'll use the XY data library for random test data generation, so let's first install that. We'll start off by removing the previous code and creating a loop that will occur 10 times. Each time we'll add a line series to the chart, where each series will display one trend in this chart. After creating the series, we use XYData to generate a dataset and push it into the series. We can save this and see that we already have a minimal working application. Note how easily LightningChart JS is able to visualize the 1 million data points we just gave it. To improve on this, let's add a legend to the chart. The legend improves the understandability of the chart and also adds some additional user interactions, like highlighting and hiding individual components. Next, let's change the x-axis to depict daytime instead of just numbers. The daytime tick strategy interprets x values as millisecond timestamps. Let's increase the step between data points to highlight this. By default, the XY data outputs x values with just step of 1. Let's increase this to exactly 1 minute step between each data point. Let's translate the timestamps to a bit more recent range. This kind of implementation is simple and works well if high precision and zooming is not required. As you can see, zooming is only possible to a range of some hours in this case. If you require more precise zooming, please refer to the daytime examples linked in video description. Last but not least, let's specify a data pattern for the line series. This tells LSA.js that every data point x value is bigger than the previous one. This is completely optional, but can have a great benefit on performance, so I strongly recommend using it whenever possible. For the next example, we'll modify this chart by placing each trend on their own y-axis. For this purpose, we'll use the dashboard component, which allows placing multiple charts inside a flexible and efficient grid structure. First, I will comment everything out and reintroduce it one part at a time. When a dashboard is created, the amount of columns and rows has to be specified. In this case, we have one column and the number of rows is equal to the amount of trends or charts. I'll go with 5 trends instead of 10 this time. Now, for each trend, we also have to create a new chart, so we'll move that code inside the loop. Remember to fix the amount of trends in the loop as well. We'll also have to create the charts inside the dashboard instead of as standalone components. We can save this now and see that now each trend has its own y-axis and chart. The next issue to resolve is that there is not a lot of space in this dashboard. We'll improve this by removing the titles. That's better, but there are still a lot of extra x-axis labels on this dashboard, so let's remove those as well. Hiding datetime tick labels and lines requires quite many lines of code. Seems that we deleted a bit too much. That looks better. For a little bit of extra treat, let's synchronize all the x-axes in the dashboard. This might look quite intimidating, but here's what's happening in brief. Here we are listing all of the charts in an array. Here we're calling the synchronize axis intervals utility function with all the x-axis of each chart. Now all the x-axis are bound together, so if you modify one of them, all of the others will synchronize. Another little improvement we can do is to align these charts horizontally by setting a shared size for the y-axis. This will make sure that all of these y-axis allocate for exactly 60 pixels, so they will be aligned with it. Next, we'll look into changing the static data into real-time live data. First off, let's change the x-axis from datetime to time. This is best for displaying live data, since we're not interested in what day, month, or year it is. Let's change the step between data points back to just one. Next, we can get a real-time data source quite easily by changing the XY data generator to stream rather than promise. That is about 1600 data points for every trend, every second. At the moment, you can see how the X view is fitting to the entire dataset. Let's change this fitting into scrolling instead. Since all the axes are bound together, it will make most sense that we disable scrolling on all axes except one. This value here controls the duration of the time domain. You can try playing around with it. Last but not least, let us enable automatic data cleaning. This is vital for applications that run indefinitely. We have now gone through all the line chart examples in this video. For more line chart examples, you may browse our interactive examples gallery. Here are some highlights. Real-time scrolling with UI for modifying the stream rates and channels amount. You can use this to see how much data your device can handle. Large dataset line chart with over millions of data points. You can also edit the example and see just how far you can go. Electrocardiogram line chart, logarithmic line chart, and 3D line charts. I have also included a link in the video description to a performance comparison study of different web line chart providers. There you can learn what is the concrete difference between LightningChart and other data visualization tools. Otherwise, happy coding and see you in the next tutorials or in our technical support channels.